Well, welcome back to this e-course called The Call to Manhood. I'm David Hibbert, and in session two, we're going to be looking at the current state of manhood. And what is that current state of manhood? Well, men are experiencing confusion in life. Men are experiencing a lack of confidence in their masculinity. They are not sure how to be real men in today's society. Men are also experiencing disappointment in life. They don't seem to know how to navigate through life, making healthy choices or choosing a solid and meaningful career. And so most men are just generally disappointed with life. Men are also experiencing pain in life. You know, all of us are wounded to some degree or other, but many men are experiencing the pain that comes from a lack of confidence, that comes from confusion, that comes from rejection, that comes from failed relationships, and so much more that men are experiencing today. Men are experiencing loneliness in life. With the increase in technology has come a decrease in intimacy and friendship and camaraderie, and most men have very few close friends, and so most men are secretly very lonely. Men are experiencing aimlessness in life. Most men have no internal vision for life. They simply are reacting to life rather than engaging with life. And so they struggle with a sense of aimlessness in life. Men are trying to escape their pain. And you know, in order to escape the pain that men are feeling, they're trying to be distracted by excessive work, right? Workaholics, or excessive sports, or numb the pain through excessive alcohol or excessive gambling, or maybe even retreat into imaginary life through internet pornography or online fantasy games. Men are trying to escape the pain. Men are confused, and confused men create major problems. They create major problems in their own lives and in society in general. You know, almost every single social problem can be traced to men. For example, recent statistics say that 90% of murders are committed by men. 88% of robberies are committed by men. And 75% of all people arrested are men. You know, confused and isolated men with unresolved pain become destructive, and lonely and drifting men cause major problems in society. Well, without a vision, without a motivating vision for manhood, men will settle for a lot less in life. You know, without a moving, a compelling, a passionate, and a motivational vision for manhood, men will just settle for a lot less. Men will settle for a less than life. Men will settle, they'll be involved in a less than marriage. They'll settle for less than relationships, a less than job, less than family, and less than accomplishments in life. They settle for a lot less when they don't have vision. Well, how did men get into this state? How did we get in this state? Let's talk about the historical roots of our present manhood crisis. Well, number one, there's racism and prejudice. You know, because of racism, men from certain races were less likely to get a good job or to get a well-paying job. And so they were less likely to get a promotion at work or into a place of management. And as a result, it was so much more difficult for men of certain races to provide adequately for their families or to be home in the evenings or weekends with their children, which is what is desirable, right? Because of racism, some men had to settle for the worst shifts, for the weekend shifts, for the night shifts, and never getting that promotion where they could really use their talents to provide for their family. Then came along the Industrial Revolution, and there was physical separation for dad. Because in previous generations, as we know, boys were raised to follow in their father's footsteps. And so most boys spent their days all day long with their father, being trained by their father, talking to their father, interacting with their father, asking questions of their father, and being called into manhood by their father. And so with their father, they learned a work ethic, they learned creativity, they learned leadership, and every father understood the importance of calling their sons into manhood. But with the Industrial Revolution, fathers went off to work and left their sons at home to be trained by their mother and by the school system. Third thing that happened was wars. And in wars, boys suffered physical and emotional separation from dad. See, men went off to war, and so sons were physically separated by their from their fathers. But then men came back from war. They returned from war mentally and emotionally scarred by the horrors of war, and so they became emotionally disconnected from their own lives and from their family around them. And so families suffered because of a father's emotional separation. Then let's talk about education. Here are some, and really the lack of male role models in our modern educational system. Here's some statistics. These are the latest. I get 2011 Canadian statistics, and it's now 2020, so they're a lot worse, right? But here's the 2011 statistics. We put our children in daycare, which is almost 100% staffed by women. Then we put them into preschool, which is 97% staffed by women. Then we put them into elementary school, which is 84% staffed by women. Then we put them into secondary school, which is 60% staffed by women. And then we graduate them into society, and we tell our boys, be a man. And even though the boys have had very few, if any, male role models through the educational system. And as I said, that was 2011. The gender gap has even widened in the school system since then. Also, let's talk about fractured families where there's a lack of male influence. Again, I have some 2011 Canadian statistics. Because of family breakdowns, 79%, that's almost 80% of single parents or single parent families are headed by women. Only 9% of children, get this, only 9% of children have equal time with both mother and father, and only about 20% of single parent children have reasonable amounts of time with their fathers. 1 in 5 have reasonable amounts of time with their fathers. Let's talk about feminism and the push for sameness. The feminist movement has tried to argue that men and women are the same, and you don't need men and women. As long as you have one, everything's great. You can just interchange man and women, no problem at all. Either can contribute to a child what a child really needs. But the truth is that men and women are indeed equal, but they are not the same, and both men and women can each make separate and unique contributions to their children that the other spouse cannot make. And let's talk quickly about extended adolescence, delaying manhood. You know, because of the confusion and the frustration of manhood, many men are holding on to their adolescence. Men in their 20s and even 30s and 40s are still playing video games or role-playing games, and they're involved in other distractions that we normally associate with the activities of adolescence. And all of these things and more are contributing to the present manhood crisis. So what's the solution? Really, what is the solution? Well, number one, we need real men who will model manhood to us and mentor us in the issues of manhood. You know, we need men we can look up to as real men to show us how to live as men. Number two, we need real men who will spend time with us and hold us accountable to manhood issues. You see, every man needs a man to hold him accountable to manhood responsibilities. Now, third thing, we need natural fathers who will nurture their children and make manhood contributions and call sons into manhood. Now more than ever, we need a new generation of godly fathers to rise up and speak in the lives of their sons. Fourth, we need spiritual fathers who will nurture younger men and make manhood contributions and call spiritual sons into manhood, just like Paul did for Timothy. You know, because for various reasons, not every boy has access to a natural father, but we should all have access to a spiritual father. And so every man needs to accept the call to become a spiritual father. And that's number five. Every man needs to respond to the call to become a real man and take up his responsibility to mentor and model manhood. You know, I want to pray for you again, and I have an assignment for you, okay? Father, in Jesus' name, I just thank you for the men that are watching. And Lord, I pray that they would understand why they've been held back as men because of all the societal contributions to hindering them as men. But I pray they would also accept the call to rise up as men. And each man would, for the sake of others, make the choice to become a male role model. And they would also make the choice to find someone who will model manhood to them. Lord, I pray against pride and independence and all those things that would rob men from stepping up as men. Lord, I just pray against the pride, the fear, the independence, and I pray every man would humble themselves and find a man to mentor, model, and mentor manhood to them, and then be a man who will do that for others. In Jesus' name, amen. Your assignment, number one, what issue in your life do you think has contributed the most to your manhood struggles? Try to identify it. What thing do you feel you need the most in your life to overcome your manhood struggles? Where will you go to get the help you need? And who will be that person who will help you overcome your manhood struggles? Now is not a time for pride, guys. Now is a time to humble yourself and find that person or those people. Maybe you have a group of men. Man, I encourage you to be part of a men's group. And number four, who needs your help in order to respond to the call of manhood? And what will you do to help them take up the challenge to not just be mentored as a man, but then mentor someone else? Well, I hope you enjoyed this session. I want to encourage you to come back to session three, and we're going to look at a biblical mandate for men. Hope to see you again soon. Bless you.